Electromagnetic induction. Faraday's law of electromagnetic induction is also called the law of electromagnetism. This law explains the operational principle of electric generators, electric inductors, electrical transformers, and electric motors. It helps in understanding important points that lead to the electromagnetic induction or production of electricity. Faraday's law is conducted to see the way magnetic fields change due to the flow of current in wires. This law was first projected in 1831 by a chemist and physicist, Michael Faraday. Because of him, the law got its name. Faraday's law is the outcome of the observations of the three main experiments that he had conducted. Through these experiments, he found the principle of electromagnetic induction. Faraday's first law. The first law of Faraday's electromagnetic induction explains that when a wire is kept in a field that experiences a constant change in its magnetic field, then an electromagnetic field is developed. This phenomenon of development of the electromagnetic field is called an induced EMF. If it is a closed circuit, then a current also gets induced inside the circuit. It is called induced current. There are four means to change the magnetic field in a circuit. 1. By rotation of the coil in relation to the magnet. 2. By movement of the coil into the magnetic field or outside the magnetic field. 3. By modifying the region of a coil that is kept in the magnetic field. 4. By movement of a magnet in the direction of the coil or against the direction of the coil. Faraday's second law. Now let us understand the second law of Faraday. This is another law by Faraday on electromagnetic induction. The law explains that the EMF induced in a conductor is equivalent to the rate at which the flux is linked to the circuit changes. Here, this flux is the product of the flux in the wire and the number of turns present in the wire. Let us see how Faraday's law was established. Let us first understand the terms. Where epsilon equals the EMF or electromotive force. Phi equals the magnetic flux. N equals the total number of turns in the coil. The rate at which the magnetic flux changes through the circuit is equal to the amount of the electromotive force developed in the circuit. The above statement can be written in the following equation. Epsilon equals dt divided by d phi. The electromotive force, or EMF, is the difference in the potential developed across an unloaded loop. This happens when the resistance present in the circuit reaches a high level. As EMF and voltage, both are measured in voltage, so one can consider EMF as voltage too. There is another important law that describes electromotive force, like Faraday's law. Lenz's law was postulated in 1833 by Heinrich Lenz. Where Faraday's law describes the amount of the EMF generated inside the circuit, Lenz's law tells about the direction of the flow of current in the circuit. The law explains that the direction of the current will be opposite to the direction of flux that produced it. In other words, the direction of any magnetic field generated by the induced current is opposite to the modification in the actual field. Lenz's law comes to the same conclusion as made by Faraday's law. The only difference is the minus sign. This negative sign is an indication that the direction of the magnetic field and the direction of induced EMF have opposite signs. E equals minus dt divided by d phi. If there are n number of turns in the coil, then the total magnetic induction in a coil is represented as E equals minus n dt divided by d phi. In the first Faraday's law, it was stated that when the total strength of the magnetic field changes, then only it induces a current in the circuit. This was proved by connecting an ammeter to the wire loop. This ammeter gets deflected with the movement of the magnet in the direction of the wire. In Faraday's second experiment, it was stated that when the current passes through the iron rod, it makes it electromagnetic. He also observed that due to relative motion between the coil and the magnet, an induced electromagnetic force gets produced. When the magnet rotates about the axis, then no EMF is produced, whereas when the magnet rotates on its axis, then it produces induced EMF. When the magnet is stationary or fixed at its place, then no deflection was observed in the ammeter. When the magnet moves close to the coil, the voltage that was measured rose to its peak. When the magnet moves away from the wire, the amount of voltage generated is in the opposite direction of the loop. The third experiment was conducted and recorded. In this experiment, when the coil was stationary, it produced no deflection in the galvanometer. Thus, induced current was generated in the coil. But, when the magnet moved far from the circuit, then the ammeter showed deflection away from the loop.